today we're coming to you from an airplane. Hello everyone, welcome back to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect, where we learn about conservation careers, wildlife species, and all kinds of technology that are used to study and protect wildlife. We are meeting pilot biologist Steve Earsom with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Now, Steve spends a good deal of his time in the cockpit of a plane doing his part for conservation. Let's meet up with him to find out just what his job is really like. Steve, it's so very nice to meet you. Thank you so much for having us at your airport. And I've got to ask you, how did you become interested in a career in conservation as a pilot biologist?
Well, I grew up just running around in fields and streams and hunting and fishing, so I really grew up outdoors, and that was sort of the basis for my love of nature. And then I started studying biology, and as things went along, I found out that you could actually combine careers of aviation and biology, and that's what brought me to where I am today.
What exactly does a pilot biologist do anyway?
Oh, it's amazing. It's really cool. So, you know, a lot of biologists get to do things out in the field. So they will walk or hike out in the field to collect information. Others may drive a truck or a boat or an ATV, things like that. I actually get to collect information on wildlife for its conservation from an airplane. But a lot of what we do is actually surveys for migratory birds. So migratory birds are things like ducks and geese and eagles, anything that spends part of its life, you know, in a given year in one part of the world and goes somewhere else for another part of its life. Well, so what we do is we fly the airplane really low and really slow. So we fly our surveys at about 150 or 200 feet above the ground, so right above the treetops. That gives us just a second or two to see a duck or a goose and allows us just enough time to identify that bird.
Would you mind giving me and some of the viewers a little lesson on how to identify some of the birds that you see?
Right, sure. So we start out with a habitat. So we know that there's some bird species that you'll find in big lakes or out in the ocean where there's no land around anywhere at all. And then there's other species that you'll find in little tiny wetlands. So we like to call them puddle ducks. And then the second step is how the bird takes off from the water. So if the bird flies off the water and they're a puddle duck, they take off like a rocket. I mean, it's like almost straight up. The third area refinement to keep moving more and more birds out of the possibility is how they actually look. So some of the birds, they look like footballs. You know, they're big, fat, and they got these little stubby wings, and they look like they can't hardly fly. Or other birds are really long and slender, have these really slender wings, and they have a slower wing beat. And then finally, you get to actually the markings. You know, what's the bird got on? So for example, you know, like a mallard. He's got a big green head, and if you see a mallard flying, he almost has this white horseshoe on the tail. Makes them really easy to identify from the air. A present that I've brought for you.
Oh.
It is a flight suit.
All right.
And let's see how that works for you. Yeah, that looks like a perfect fit to me.
I think it's perfect, yeah.
Yeah. So this is basically, this is a flight suit that you see a lot of people who fly airplanes use. And it's made out of a special material, and it's the same kind of material that firefighters wear. And it just helps protect our body against fires.
Next, Steve treated me to a quick flight to check my new identification skills. And as we flew over a wetland, I was able to make out the telltale markings of mallard ducks below. But all too soon, it was time to come back down. Steve, that was awesome. I just had the time of my life. Thank you so very much. And I know everyone watching is pretty jealous of the type of job you do, so I have to ask on behalf of them, what can they do to get a job just like yours?
You know, the key is just spending time outdoors in nature and learning birds and learning all the animals that you can learn. You don't have to live out in the country to do that. Even if you live in a neighborhood, there's always a park around, or even if you can't get to the park, you can always look out your window. There's an amazing number of birds that you can see out your window and start learning to identify them. And the two things that you can use to really help you in identifying birds is a field guide.
Okay.
And that has all the markings of the birds, and it talks about their habitats that they use and what times of year that they're going to be in your neighborhood. And then also, if you can get a pair of binoculars, that can really help you identify the specifics on the bird. And that gets you a long ways down the way to becoming a biologist pilot.
Well, I think this is fantastic advice. Steve, thank you so much again. Great meeting you.
Great to meet you.
Remember, any of you guys watching can have a job just like this. How awesome would that be? Thanks, everyone, and we'll see you next time on the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect.